When you think about getting ready for an NFL game, you have to wonder, what will they throw at us that maybe we haven't seen before? Two-minute drill? Maybe different things like that? Gotta be prepared. You're exactly right.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be fielded at the six. And he'll be brought down here as the penalty flags come in right away, and we may have a face mask here right at the start. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10.
Let's bring it.
On the counter, Ingram. And whoa, he's going to hope that that is not a sign of things to come. A rude welcoming to this ball game. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll be a second and long. Okay, there's a tone setter. First play from scrimmage, stuff them in the backfield.
You know what they were doing last night in the hotel room? Visualizing exactly that. That's what they were thinking about. Making that play, having leverage lower than the offensive lineman, getting into the offensive backfield, knocking someone down. Just what you said, setting the tone early for this game.
Jeez, you are fired up.
When I see a play like that, I can't help it.
On second and 15 now, Griffin. Hollywood Brown, the intended receiver, but now it's third down. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
Third and long, it's Griffin. They go screen, this is Ingram. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. He went backwards 5 yards there on third down to bring up fourth.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. But he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked out inside the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. As the Titans come back out onto the field here, this is a crew, Charles, that made a heck of a run in the middle of the season, but they might look back at that Week 15 loss at home to Houston as the one that was the turn in the wrong direction.
Had everything going in their direction, to use your word, right? Because remember, that run led to Houston coming to their place in the feature game of the week in the AFC, and they didn't win it. Remember last year, they lost to the Colts at home in Week 17, and that kept them out of the playoffs. This is a good team. Whether they make the playoffs or not, they do have a big decision to make at the quarterback spot next year. Will Ryan Tannehill, who played so well in relief of Marcus Mariota this year, will he be re-signed by Tennessee? Or will he decide he wants to try it somewhere else? That's a big question for the Titans to answer.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Mariota hands to Henry. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Mariota gives to Henry. this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down.
This offense really put themselves in a tough spot on first and second down, needing long yardage to try and pick up a first down, and they ended up getting a great run. Explosive, picked up nice yardage. You don't expect to be in this situation on fourth down, but guess what? It all started with what happened on first and second down. Really put them behind the eight ball.
On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Here's Moore on the return. That's a 49-yard punt, eight, though, on the return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. As the Ravens come back out here on offense, we talked about Lamar Jackson earlier, Charles, but these Ravens, they rolled through the middle part of the season. Couple losses in September, but undefeated in October, November, and rolled that into December. They've answered every big question thus far. The wins over Seattle, New England, Houston, the Rams, the Niners and Bills as well. Are they the favorites to hoist the Lombardi Trophy in Miami on February 2nd?
I believe they are because they are a complete team. As much as Lamar Jackson powers everything on offense, he has Marquise Hollywood Brown out wide. He can throw the ball deep too. Dependable tight ends led by Mark Andrews. Really good offensive line. Mark Ingram can run it. The defense comes at you from every imaginable angle. And if you're trying to prepare on offense for them, it is hard to do, and your quarterback gets hit a lot. And they have the best kicker in the league in Justin Tucker. That's a big formula for success when come playoff time.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Here's Snead as they run the jet sweep. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
I'm not sure that you'd call it a trick play, but it definitely showed some imagination there. I wouldn't be surprised if they want to come back and show this play a few more times before this one is over.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
54, right there. 54, Mike.
Quarterback, don't get nervous now. We ain't beginning to turn you up.
On second down, Ingram. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
On third down, Griffin. And that is incomplete. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
Now Justin Tucker. He has hit from 61 in his career, so he has the leg for this. This will be from 56 yards out. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one as it's good from 56 yards out. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3-0.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3-0. I went 3-0 on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now here's a throw that's taken in by Tajay Sharp, and they're able to get this one across the 35. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Three nothing after one on EA Sports. A quick pass to Davis. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be 3rd down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on 3rd. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. He can run for it, and he will. Muscles him off. And a nice job there defensively. They get him to the ground short of the first, right around the 42. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up 4th down.
That was a good effort there, trying to do it on his own, but as a defender, you're in a tough spot because you have coverage responsibilities behind you, and if you take off too quick to try and get him down, he might loft it over your head.
So better to track with your man defensively than try to go up and make a stop on the quarterback.
Exactly right. What you're hoping is that your guys in the front 7 can get him down.
Here's Brett Kern now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. They've shown very little offensively to this point. Well, neither team has really. They come up here now 1st down. RG3 going to bring the Ravens up 1st and 10 at the 20. To throw is RG3. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Now 2nd and 7 from the 23. And no pitch there and no chance either as he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that's going to bring up a 3rd down.
And on this play, the read for the quarterback was the defensive end, and he was totally focused on the quarterback. He should have given it off inside to the running back. Instead, he kept it and ended up taking a loss on the play.
Got an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for 3rd down. Here's Griffin to throw. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. A 5-yard loss there is going to bring up fourth down.
What a catch and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves, they do have a little grip to them, don't they?
They get a little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
On is the punter, Cook, who sends it away. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And it'll be Titan football. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
40. A first down throw for Mariota. This will be caught by Brown. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. First down, Titans, gain of 12.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Mariota. It's caught by Davis. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 23 yards, the final tally. Remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
Here's a four receiver look now. Three of those guys out to the right side on second and eight. Again, it's Mariota. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Corey Davis, the intended receiver. Third down here.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will tie us at 3-3. So they do get 3 points, but that's now three drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
Field goals, all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
They'll throw on first down to Griffin, rolling to his right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Rashad Evans, the linebacker, recording the sack there. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable 2nd and 13. Here's Griffin. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. They run. It's Mark Ingram. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number 1. On 1st down, out to his left. The Ravens going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the 1st half. Could we get a touchdown in this 1st half after all? It's 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Griffin. Sneed's got it. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Griffin. Got a man, it's Brown. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore 1st down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. Tucker's kick is good. And they will take the lead here in this battle of field goals at 6-3. Now the drive ends in just three, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Let's go, boys, bring it up!
And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their own 22. Second half begins with a run by Henry. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. First down carry for Henry, and they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
go deep.
Again, it's Henry. And an alley to run. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
48.
They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Give him 7 yards on the play as they do pick up the third down conversion. And we were down on the field watching Henry warm up before the game. He's a big man. No wonder he breaks those tackles.
And you remember what I told you when we were watching? It's not all pads. Yeah. I mean, you get him out of pads and just see him in a regular suit or an outfit. He is a huge human being and a lot faster than what people know. When he gets rolling, he's a lot to bring down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Throwing on second and 8. Mariota stepping up. He'll try and run. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. Mariota from the gun on third down. And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. From the gun, Mariota. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete. Defensively, that's Earl Thomas, the all-pro safety, knocking it free.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Back to the ground now. It's Henry. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here. Brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
Escaping the pressure. And he's going to score. It's a Titans touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Titans are going to retake the lead. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns third and goal into a touchdown. Extra point right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second
half? Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
RG3 going to bring the Ravens up first and 10 at their own 24. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. After seeing that, maybe time to go back to some downfield throws here.
Yeah, anything. Change it up, because the teams that win, the best teams, they're the ones that make adjustments. Doesn't mean you can't come back to what you thought you could get done. Sometimes when you open things up a little bit, you can get back to what you wanted to do before.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Again, they'll run with Ingram. 8 yards on the run, and that cuts this down to a third and about 5.
Kidd had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. From the gun on third down, Griffin. And this is going to be incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here's Sam Cook now as he's on to punt for Baltimore. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. And the Titans getting set to go. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. They begin with Henry, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down.
No gain on the play, second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The rush defense stout on first down. Here's second and 10 from the 20. Mariota to Lewis on the draw. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. Gotta figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just gonna be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
On third down, Mariota. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon.
Yeah, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Here's Brett Kern now, standing just about on his own goal line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Go, tackle, let's go. We got this, we got this.
From the shotgun, Griffin. Rolling to his left. Now he'll pull it down. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Throwing again on second down. Griffin, they'll roll him out right. And he's going to keep it here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. It's, at this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
On first down, Griffin. And the pressure getting to RG3. He's brought down for the sack. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it, but it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Throwing on second down, Griffin. Open man is the tight end, Nick Boyle. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 12 yards to pick up there, good for a Raven first.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
On first and 10, it's Griffin. It's complete to Snead. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. To throw again on second down. Griffin, oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll look to throw. He's got Snead. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Nick Boyle that time, but it'll be second and goal. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Cameron Wake with a little wake-up call as he gets in there for the sack.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense. So the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Now RG3. He's got it to Ingram, complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone. And now it'll be fourth and goal. They'll come out in the pistol. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
A score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a three-point lead. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told, and it's capped off with a Ravens touchdown. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. So now Mariota and the Titans down 13-10, 35 seconds to go. They need at minimum 3 points out of this as they come up first and 10. Throw. He's got his man Shard complete. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Here's Mariota, stepping up, he's going to keep it. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. They'll try to run for it. Lewis. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Mariota on fourth down. That is caught. It's Tajay Sharp. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you were wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.